Rob just showed us how we can make things accessible to anyone who can't use a mouse or pointing device. Whether that's because of any type of physical impairment, or a technology issue, or simply personal preference. You would have seen that while it definitely requires some care and thought, it's not a huge amount more work if you plan it from the beginning. And once that work is done, you're already a long way down the path to a fully accessible site. Already, you've made your site usable by more people than if you hadn't addressed keyboard usability, and given your site a more polished, completed feel. In this lesson, we're going to build on that work and get you thinking about other accessibility factors. Like, how do we build our websites to support users like Victor who can't see the screen at all? We'll start with some background on assistive technology, the general term for things like screen readers. These are tools that are designed to help users whose impairments can prevent them from accessing information technology at all. Next up, we'll take a look at some general user experience concepts. We'll build on those to take a deeper dive into the experience of users of assistive technology. Then finally, we'll move into how we can use HTML effectively to create a good experience for these users. And we'll see that it actually does overlap quite a lot with the way we address focus. First, let's talk a bit about assistive technology.